So, I read through the materials that we were sent to prepare for this thing, and it said present a positive. So I think I've got a positive. It also said nobody wants to have a documentary about doom and gloom. And I take issue with that, because I think people positively do want a documentary about doom and gloom. The whole media industry depends on it. So my single prop that I brought today is this week's copy of The Economist, The Next War, The Growing Threat of Great Power Conflict. This is really typical of media content on conflict. The message I'm trying to get across is it is dead wrong. War is on the decline, both war within countries, civil wars, and wars between countries, interstate wars. And we know this as an empirical fact. The reason why we know this as an empirical fact is largely due to the work of one man, Lewis Fry Richardson. Lewis Fry Richardson was a Quaker and a mathematician. At the outbreak of the First World War, he was 33, and he was working on meteorology, which at the time was something that nobody was especially interested in. Now, as a Quaker, he couldn't permit himself to enlist, but that didn't mean he didn't serve. He joined something called Friends Ambulance Brigade, so he saw service on the front lines in France. The war had a profound impact on his life. He decided to take his work on, well, before he stopped his work on meteorology. Nobody had been especially interested in meteorology, but the Air Ministry became interested in it because they found that this meant that if they understood how weather worked, they would be able to better predict the trajectory of missiles. This is the day that Richardson stopped doing research on meteorology because he didn't believe it should be used for the means of war. After the war, he realized what he could do with his research. Take exactly the same methods that he'd applied to meteorology and use them to look at human conflict, to use them to look at war, what he referred to at the time as deadly quarrels. For the large part, his research went unnoticed after his death in 1953. But from 1960 onwards, researchers realized that there was something in here that we could use, that we could replicate, that we could start using new methods to understand conflict. Those methods are still being used today. My pitch is that I will interview people who are still doing this kind of research. These people are at PRIO in Oslo, they're at Uppsala in Sweden, and they're at the University of Essex in the UK. They've used these methods, they can show us that conflict is on the decline, both interstate conflict and intrastate conflict.
Thank you very much.